हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द एटिलेस एकेडमी। आवर टुडेज लेक्चर इज बेस्ड ऑन द माइक्रोबियल एनालिसिस ऑफ वेरियस सैंपल्स व्हिच हैव बीन कलेक्टेड फ्रॉम सॉइल, वाटर एंड मिल्क। लेट्स स्टार्ट विद आवर लेक्चर एंड द टॉपिक व्हिच आई विल बी डीलिंग विद टुडे इज कंसिस्ट ऑफ, फर्स्ट इज द आइसोलेशन ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म फ्रॉम सॉइल, वाटर एंड मिल्क। Second is to obtain a pure culture of bacteria by strict split method. Third is the staining and biochemical activities of purified culture, which is again included into certain chemical test of gram staining, catalyst test, amylase test and citrate test. Let's begin our lecture with the microbial analysis. First step is to collect the sample. For the isolation of bacteria, soil sample was collected from colony garden, milk sample was collected from hotels and dairies, water sample was collected from ordinary hotels, dabas and government supply. In order to further go for the experiment, we have to learn first the serial dilution. What is the dilution? Dilution is simply to decrease the concentration level of the solute in the solution. That is why the dilution is required in order to get a less concentrated solution from high concentrated solution. And here the serial dilution regards with the in decreasing the dilution rate from one sample to another, and then from that sample to the next one and further on in a series manner. Okay, we have to isolate microorganisms from different source by using serial dilution so that the number of bacteria present in various sources would decrease by serially diluting the crude sample obtained. About 6 test tubes are taken, each containing 9 ml of distilled water. The first test tube is called the crude test tube, which is highly concentrated, which contains the microorganism in highly concentrated form. So 9 ml ml will be the stock solution in D1. In the next is the 1 ml of stock solution mixed with the 9 ml of saline solution or the distilled water. That is the D2. Now from this mixture, we again take the 1 ml of solution and again mixed in the third new solution sample, that is the D3. And further on, addition of this 1 ml from the previous test tube to the another next test tube is continued till we get the concentration level of D6, in till the dilution rate is decreases and concentration of microorganism reduces. Now this was the we have learned about the serial dilution, how we perform it. As our sample is ready, now what we have to do is, the experiment is isolation of microorganisms from soil, water and milk. In order to get isolation, in order to get the growth of that particular these three samples, firstly we have to make a media on which we grow our microbes, on which the particular growth. This media is a kind of a home for these microorganisms, or a kind of nutrients provided to these microorganisms to grow well in the given environment. So taking the media preparation, we made the 200 ml of nutrient agar media, taking 0.5% peptone, 0.3% yeast extract and 0.5% NaCl and 1.5% agar. Dissolve 1.5% agar in another 100 ml of water, boiled both dissolved solution and quickly mixed into 250 ml of conical flask. Close the mouth of the flask tightly with cotton plug and wrap it with the aluminium foil. Autoclave the media for 20 minutes with 15 psi pressure in autoclave machine, and sterilization is properly done. Now what are the procedures to be followed? After the sterilization, the media is taken out and made 3 agar plates by pouring autoclave media to 1/3 of the petri plate and mark them for each microorganism. kept all the petri plates lightly covered and kept aside to solidify the media in each plate as shown, I have shown in the figure. Next is to spread plate and pour plate method. We have to learn what is this method is about. Spread plate. 100 microliters of inoculum is taken by micropipette, poured on the petri plate, and colonies do not overlap in spread plate method. Next is the pour plate method. In contrast to spread plate method, culture is either added to the molded media, mixed and poured into the plate, or inoculum is first poured on the plate and then molded media is added. It is up to you, whichever procedure you are going through it. Okay, there is the diagram which shows the both the techniques of pouring the media and inoculating your particular microorganism on the agar plate. So here is the first pour plate method is the pipette inoculum onto a sterile plate. Then we added the molten media, swirl to mix the mix and incubate it. Colonies grow and in and on the media, means inside the media also and on the upper layer of the media also. Whereas in spread plate method, we have to pipette inoculum onto the surface of the agar plate. Means once the agar media is solidified, we have to pour our inoculum or sample method onto the surface and slowly spread evenly or either by agar surface. Then we have to put that petri plate into the incubator for incubation period and later on sees the colony's growth only on the surface of the media, not within the media or under the media. Okay, kept all the petri plates in the incubator in inverted at 34 degrees Celsius temperature. Observe the plate at different times of interval, that is after 16 hours, after 24 hours, 40 hours and 48 hours and 64 hours. Here are the growths that have been shown here in the picture of different of the three samples, milk media and milk sample, soil sample and water sample. To keep in mind that whenever you keep your petri plate inside the incubator, you always have to kept it in inverted form once you inoculate the media, because if you kept upright side, then what happens, your media will be disrupt, your media will be get what some moisture content inside the incubator. Whatever the moisture evolved from the media inside the incubator, it will come on the upper surface and later on it will drop on your media itself. But when you kept it in inverted place, your media itself will be in the upward direction. So it the chances for getting indulged with the moisture present in the petri plates will not be there. The third experiment is to obtain pure culture of bacteria by strict plate method. Okay, previously what we have to, in order to isolate a bacteria, what we have done, we have serially diluted our sample, we have inoculated it on the agar plate, and once we find the growth of the particular samples on our media, now it's a time. Third step is to purify that culture of bacteria by different methods or to get a single colony in a purified form for a particular growth. The main principle involved in this is the colony of bacteria whose pure culture is to be obtained is kept by inoculation loop and strict on a fresh media in a petri dish. There are two types of streaking. We can do it by a zigzag pattern or we can do it perform it by quadrant streaking method. For here also, in order to maintain the pure culture, we have to make another media and a fresh media is prepared for inoculating it. So bacterial culture or nutrient agar media is made of 100 ml NaM, and in which NaCl is of 0.5 gram, beef extract is of 0.3 gram, peptone of 0.5 gram, agar was 1.8 gram, and distilled water was taken as 100 ml. What are the procedures to be followed? We prepared the NAM media, autoclaved it and poured in petri dish. This I won't have to tell again and again. I have discussed in the previous slide. After the media got solidified, transfer the culture to be strict onto the petri plate. Kept the petri dish in an incubator at 37 degrees Celsius for 24 hours to preserve the purified culture. Okay, here are the streaking method that has been shown here. The first one is showing the quadrant streaking, which starts from one column, then to the next, then to the third, and then from that the fourth. And the zigzag pattern as shown in the petri plate, how the zigzag pattern is. The chances for getting a single colony is at the end of the zigzag plane. Next is the staining and biochemical activities of purified culture. Okay, now we have obtained a pure culture. Then we can go for further chemical test for a particular growth of the microorganism. First, taking the gram staining, we have to check whether the bacteria or whether the microorganism are gram positive or gram negative. We can detect it by gram staining. Gram staining is performed to check the purity of culture, whether it is contaminated by any other bacteria culture or not. This technique was developed by Hans Christian Gram to classify the bacteria into two groups, the gram positive and gram negative. Okay, what are the materials required for gram staining is, we need a crystal violet solution, a iodine solution, a 95% alcohol solution, safranin, microscope and a distilled water. Okay, these are the steps to be followed for making a gram staining slide. We have to take a clean grease-free slide. Prepare a smear of bacteria on the slide. We have to put a small sample of bacteria on the slide. Put a water drop and then a small sample of bacteria into it and make a smear. Air dry and then heat fix the smear over flame. Apply fixed drop of crystal violet stain on the slide and keep it for 2 to 60 seconds. Rinse the slide in distilled water. Apply now few drops of grams iodine on the slide and keep it for 20 to 30 seconds. Now again you have to rinse the slide in distilled water. Wash the slide with 95% ethyl alcohol for 10 to 20 seconds. Now here is the step that if the bacteria retains the dark violet or purple color, that means the gram positive bacteria, and if bacteria loses the strain, that means it is a gram negative bacteria. Wash the slide with the distilled water and counter stain with the safranin for 30 seconds and again wash with distilled water. If no change no change by counter staining and bacteria retains dark violet or purple color, it means that it is of gram positive bacteria. And if the color disappears and it will turn from violet color to red color or pink, that means it is a gram negative bacteria. The next is the catalase test, and it involves the principle that during aerobic respiration in the presence of oxygen, microorganism produces hydrogen peroxide, which is a lethal to the cell. The enzyme catalase present in the organism breaks down the hydrogen performed by adding hydrogen oxide to water and oxygen and helps them in their survival. Catalase test is performed by adding H2O2 to the culture taken on the glass slide directly, and release of free oxygen gas indicates the positive test. So for this catalase test, there is a requirement of hydrogen peroxide, that is of 3%. Okay, it has a simple, very simple and easiest procedure. We have to put 2 to 3 drops of hydrogen peroxide is taken on a three glass slides, that is of a water sample and soil sample and the milk sample. One loop full of culture was taken on each slide of milk, water and soil sample. Slide was observed after 10 minutes. ऑब्जर्वेशन, इफ दी बबल्स आर ऑब्जर्व्ड ऑन दी स्लाइड देन दे आर कैटलेज पॉजिटिव एंड इफ बबल्स इज नॉट ऑब्जर्व देन इट इज़ अ कैटलेज नेगेटिव टेस्ट. इट इज़ क्लियरली शोन इन द बिलो डायग्राम शोइंग द बबल्स इन द सॉल्यूशन एंड द अपियरेंस ऑफ बबल्स कंटेन्स द इंडिकेट्स द पॉजिटिव टेस्ट फॉर कैटलेज. द नेक्स्ट केमिकल टेस्ट इज द एमाइलेज टेस्ट. The principle involves the amylase is an exoenzyme that hydrolyzes starch, a polysaccharide into maltose, a disaccharide and some monosaccharides and such as glucose. These disaccharides and monosaccharides enter into the cytoplasm of the bacterial cell through the semi-permeable membrane and thereby used the endoenzyme. Starch is a complex carbohydrate composed of two constituents. Amylase, a straight chain polymer of 200 to 300 glucose unit, and amylopectin, a larger branch polymer with phosphate group in it. The ability to degrade starch is used a criteria for the determination of amylase production by the microbe. Starch is the presence of iodine produces a dark blue coloration of the medium and a clear zone around the colony indicates amylolytic activity. The production of amylase is supported by minimal agar media containing a particular substrate. The main requirements are the minimal agar media. We need a nutrient agar slant culture, grams iodine solution. We need petri dishes, inoculation loop and Bunsen burner. Okay, what are the procedure for making minimal agar media? We have to take potassium dihydrogen phosphate of 0.3 gram. We need a disodium hydrogen phosphate of 0.6 gram. NaCl in 0.5 gram, magnesium sulfate up to 0.02 gram, ammonium chloride 0.2 gram, starch 0.8 gram, and agar of 2 gram. A single strict inoculation was made into the center of the approximately labeled petri dish containing the minimal agar media. The inoculated petri dishes were incubated for 48 hours at 37 degrees Celsius in inverted position. The surface of the plate was flooded with the gram iodine solution with a dropper and was left for 30 minutes. The excess iodine is poured off. What the observation we see? The petri plates were examined for starch hydrolysis around the colony that the color change of the media. Result: after adding the grams iodine color solution, the color did not change to blue, so it gives a negative test. Showing no color change after the addition of grams iodine, so bacterial sample does not possess any amylase activity. And if it do so, then the result is shown as given below. Next is the citrate test. Citrate test is used to differentiate among enteric bacteria on basis of their ability to utilize a ferment citrate as sole carbon source. The utilization of citrate depends on the presence of enzyme citrate produced by the organism that breaks down the citrate to oxaloacetic acid back and carbon dioxide. The citrate test is performed by inoculating the microorganism into organic synthetic medium, that is the Simon citrate agar. When citric acid is metabolized, the carbon dioxide generated combines with the sodium and water to form sodium carbonate alkaline product that changes the color of the nutrient broth from green to blue, and this constitutes a positive test. So this was the principle that was involved behind the citrate test of any microbial activity. The main requirements for this test is we need a nutrient broth culture of bacteria, the Simon citrate agar slant, a Bunsen burner, and an inoculation loop.
Okay, procedure. We have to prepare a Simon citrate agar slant. Composition, the given composition is for 1000 ml. We need an ammonium dihydrogen phosphate of 1 gram, sodium chloride 5 gram, sodium citrate 2 gram, magnesium sulfate 0.2 gram, agar of 15 gram, dipotassium phosphate 1 gram, bromothymol blue indicator, distilled water of 1000 ml. All the constituents except phosphate, which are to be dissolved separately in 100 ml of water, were dissolved and the volume was made up to 1 liter. The pH was set to 7.3 and the medium was poured in the culture tube and sterilized by autoclaving at 15 Albi pressure for 15 minutes. The Simon citrate agar slant were inoculated with the nutrient broth by means of an inoculation loop. The test tube were inoculated at 37 degrees Celsius for 48 hours to observe the color change. Okay, here are the observations. The color changed from greenish to blue of the broth due to the citrate utilization. Result, the broth color observed was red in due to the breakdown of citrate in Simon citrate media. The green color shows the negative test and the somewhat blue color indicates the positive test for citrate production by the bacteria in the media. Thank you for being with us. I hope you have enjoyed the lecture today and understood all the isolation techniques for microbial techniques involved. For more information, please log on to our website www.atlsacademy.com and register yourself for industrial summer training program.